Party of India. I give my revolutionary greetings, salutes, lal salam to all of you. Friends, comrades, I have come here to express my party's support, my party's solidarity to Mr. Kejriwal, who has taken up a very serious issue, a pertinent issue which concerns the entire nation and its future. Ever since BJP came to power, ever since Mr. Modi became Prime Minister, there is increasing attack on the very constitution of our country. The constitution which we have today was given by Dr. Ambedkar and galaxy of leaders. This constitution defines India as a secular democratic republic. Ever since BJP came to power, they are trying to impose an ideology, they are trying to implement an agenda which is sectarian, divisive, communal, fascist. This is what we should understand. And wherever the fascists capture power, wherever the fascists emerge to capture the administration, they first destroy all the institutions. I'm not going to speak about CPI. I'm not going to speak about RBI. I'm not going to speak about ED or IT. I am going to speak about Parliament, Parliament, Parliament. Ever since Modi became Prime Minister, the institution of Parliament is undermined. The institution of Parliament is bypassed, and they think they can bring laws, legislations, bypassing the Parliament, behind the back of Parliament, minimizing the role of Parliament. This is what we should try to understand. Mr. Modi said, maximum governance, minimum government. In reality, what is happening? It is maximum Modi, maximum government, minimum governance. And it has become minimum parliament. Minimum parliament. If parliament is made minimum, where is democracy? Where is democracy? I am asking you. That is why we are saying democracy is in peril. Democracy is under attack. Constitution is under attack. Democracy is under attack. Parliament has become minimum. Parliament has been made irrelevant. What to do? Everywhere, this is not India's case. When Hitler emerged as ruler of Germany, you must know the first attack was on Reichstag, the parliament of Germany. The parliament of Germany was attacked, and parliament was made irrelevant, defunct. Can you allow such a situation in India? What is the character of Indian parliament? Dr. Ambedkar, I bow to Dr. Ambedkar, this great genius who said India should always remain a democratic republic. No place for theocracy. India is a country of tremendous diversities. We have cultural diversities, we have linguistic diversities, we have ethnic diversities, we have religious diversities. Country is a country of diversities. Instead of celebrating these diversities, the BJP RSS combine is trying to impose a medieval, illiberal, moralistic ideology which we can call Hindu Rashtra, Hindutva, which has to be fought and defeated. Dr. Ambedkar addressed this question. Dr. Ambedkar said, India should never become a Hindu Rashtra. India should never become a Hindu Raj. If at all, Hindu Raj, It was said by Dr. Ambedkar. He said, if your tall Hindu Rashtra becomes a reality, it will be a calamity for the nation. Now I am asking you, can you allow, do you allow such a calamity to happen to other nation? India is our nation. We are the citizens of India. We are the children of India. And India belongs to us. We belong to India. India doesn't belong to the scientists who want to turn this country as a theocratic nation. India does not belong to them. That is where we all should understand the gravity of the situation. BJP in power is a threat to the nation. BJP in power is a threat to the constitution. BJP in power is a threat to the democracy of our country. In order to save the nation, if you want to save the nation, if you want to save the constitution of Dr. Ambedkar, if you want to save democracy, BJP must be defeated. BJP must be defeated. That is why you travel across the country, starting from Tamil Nadu to Jammu and Kashmir, or Maharashtra to Manipur. What do you hear? Desh Bachao, BJP Hatao. This is what we are hearing. I keep traveling. This is what people want. Desh Bachao. Save the nation. Save the constitution. Save democracy. Please defeat BJP. Now I am asking you in Delhi, the national capital of India. Are you prepared to defeat BJP? Defeat Modi. And this message should go across the country. Let us all unite together. Save nation, save constitution, save democracy. And let us get the country forward. I once again take this opportunity to support Mr. Arvind Kejriwal for this initiative of discussing a serious issue, the attack on institutions in public. I congratulate him. I wish him all the best. Thank you very much.